Welcome to our lesson for today. So last time we talked about how David went and he said with confidence and with bravery that no one is stronger than our God. Not even the giant, and that God will give us victory over the Philistines. And because of this, Saul agreed and he said, okay, David, you can go and fight Goliath.
Yes, but now when Saul looked at David, he thought that if David is going to fight Goliath, then he has to be fully protected.
Yes.
And so what Saul did is he took his armor and he put it on David.
Yes.
So he made David wear his armor and the
helmet, the shield, everything, his whole armor.
Yes.
And when David wore all of his armor, he could hardly move.
He
couldn't move. It was so big and it was so heavy and he could not move. Then David said, I cannot fight like
this. He was actually out of breath and he said, I cannot go to war like this. And he removed the armor and everything that Saul had.
Because he was not a soldier. He said, I am not a soldier. So he removed all of it. He took all of it off the armor and everything.
Yeah.
And he went back to the tools. He said,
I'm going to use what I am used to and what I am comfortable with.
And what I trust.
Yes.
So he took all of that off. Then he went down to a stream and he collected five smooth stones.
Yeah.
And he collected five smooth stones and put them in his bag. And then he held a stick with one hand. A shepherd's stick. Remember, he was taking care of the sheep. So he had a shepherd's stick in one hand and a sling in the other hand. And that was how he went to face Goliath.
He actually marched towards Goliath. And when Goliath saw him coming with a stick and on one hand and a sling on another hand, he was very angry.
He was angry and upset and he started cursing David and he said, do you think I am a dog? Now that you're coming here, you're coming to me with a stick? Do you think I'm a dog? And Goliath cursed David and he cursed him in the name of the Philistine gods.
But David replied to Goliath and he said, you come to me with a sword, a spear, and a javelin, but I come to you in the name of the Lord
of heaven's armies, and he is going to give us victory because there is no one who is stronger, no champion, and no giant,
and no soldier, and
no soldier is stronger than our God. And then David said, today I will kill you and I will cut off your head, and the dead bodies of your men I will give them to the birds and the wild animals. And he said this confidently and strongly. And then he ran towards Goliath. He started running towards Goliath. And he took a stone. And he took his sling.
And he fitted the stone in the sling. And he swung it. And then he released it and threw it on Goliath. And when it landed on Goliath, it hit him right on his forehead. And Goliath went tumbling down. And
face forward.
Yeah.
And he fell face flat onto the ground. And then David went. He killed him. He took his sword and he cut off Goliath's head.
And that is how David killed Goliath. And then, as he had said, he actually gave his head to the birds of the he lifted it up like this, and everyone could see. And when the Philistines saw that their mighty champion,
their big giant, their strong champion had fallen, they all scattered and they ran away as fast
and
as they could.
They ran for their lives because their mighty champion had fallen. And this is because David was confident enough to believe that God was on their side and that no one and nothing was stronger than their God. And because he was confident, he went on to fight Goliath with just a sling and a stone.
Imagine, that is what he was used to. Yes, God used a stone and a sling, and with that he brought down a mighty giant. Not a sword, not anything else.
Yes.
Just those simple things.
Yeah.
This shows us that God can use anything to give us victory and that he will always give us victory. So now it's time for us to sing our song. So everyone stand up and help us sing this song.
Oh, yeah.
Okay kids, so we've just talked about how David defeated Goliath with just a sling and a stone, and he swung it round and round and round, and he threw it, and it went, and it hit Goliath in the head. And then now how David defeated Goliath and God gave them victory. Yes. So now we're going to sing a song about exactly what we've just talked about. So everyone stand up and help us sing this song.
Yeah.
Only a boy named David, only a little sling. Only a boy named David, but he could pray and sing. Only a boy named David, only a rippling brook. Only a boy named David, but five little stones he took. And one little stone went in the sling, and the sling went round and round. And one little stone went in the sling, and the sling went round and round. And round and round and round and round and round and round and round. That one little stone went up in the air, and the giant came tumbling down. Only a boy named David, only a little sling. Only a boy named David, but he could pray and sing. Only a boy named David, only a rippling brook. Only a boy named David, but five little stones he took. And one little stone went in the sling, and the sling went round and round. And one little stone went in the sling, and the sling went round and round. And round and round and round and round and round and round and round. That one little stone went up in the air, and the giant came tumbling down. And the giant came tumbling down. And the giant came tumbling down. Okay, kids, so we've just talked about how David defeated Goliath using only a sling and five stones that he picked up from the stream. So now we are going to make our sling and our stones so that we always remember that God didn't need anything else. He didn't need a sword. He didn't need a spear. He just used David and these simple tools.
So now we're going to make David's tools of war. And what we need for this is actually white manila paper or any color of manila paper. Then you need another another piece of manila paper for us to stick our craft on. And then the other thing, we have pieces of brown paper that we are going to use to represent our stones. And remember, there were five, so we need five pieces of brown paper. And then the other thing we have here is a piece of paper that's written, for the battle below, for the battle is the Lord's. And our reference scripture where that story of David is in 1 Samuel chapter 17 and verse 47. So you can go ahead and read that scripture, and then you get to know what it says. So what we did with our first piece of manila paper, which was the white one, is we drew a letter Y. So we drew a capital letter Y, but then we made it in 3D, and then we just cut it out using scissors. So the only thing I did is to draw a capital Y in 3D, and then I cut it out. So that is going to represent our sling. Then we also need a piece of ribbon to represent the string that's right there on top of the
at the top of the sling.
Yeah, of the sling. Then, of course, the stone. So we'll start with sticking the ribbon on the sling to give it, to make the sling complete. So I'll just use my stapler, fix it right there. And the other side also, fix it right there. So there you have it. Your sling is ready. So this is what David used. And the other thing he used were five pieces of stones that he collected from the stream.
Yes.
So we're going to stick all these on this paper to just make it firm. So what I'll do is I'll take my glue. Just a little bit.
Yeah, just a little bit of glue. Take it round on the stones or on the paper, and then stick the stones onto your first manila paper.
Oh, yeah.
So make sure you only have five stones, because David only collected five
smooth stones.
Yeah. And this is what he used to defeat Goliath.
Yes.
So stick all of your five stones
right on one side of your manila paper. So once you have all your stones
stuck,
then we are going to stick our sling right at the side where let me move this stone right there. So we are going to stick this to make our craft complete. And for this one, I'm just going to staple it in like that, and on this other side, and on this other side.
So now we have a sling and we have stones.
Yeah, so now we have a sling and stones, and these are what David used. And then we are going to stick our piece of paper that we have the scripture on, and the title for the battle is the Lord's. And we're going to stick that right at the top of our manila paper, like that. And this will always remind us that the battle that David won on that day was actually the Lord's battle, because Goliath was a giant,
a huge one,
but David only used a sling and a stone to defeat him and to bring him down. So that's our craft today, and that's our lesson today. Until next time, bye!